This presentation will give you overview about communication between threads. In general, threads are the unit of execution of program. A single program can be divided into number of threads. So, complete a task, all threads need to communicate. Then, communication between threads can be achieved by the following concept. First one, condition variables, signals, message queue, and pipes. All these concepts require operating system support for sending and receiving. The following are the overall mechanism for message passing. First one, memory, shared memory, and memory mapped files. Condition variables, signals and events, message queue, named pipes. Other approaches are to share data between threads. And apart from all these concepts, the threads store its private data. First, we will see memory, shared memory and memory mapped files. This is the easiest way of communication. Two threads share a common memory, then memory access and communication will be very faster. But the problem with this approach is we need to control the write operation. In this case of process, all process have individual address space by default. If we need inter-process communication, we need to pre-configure certain region of memory as shared memory. Now, we will see how to create and delete shared memory. For this, one of the process participating in the inter-process communication need to make a library call to create a shared memory. The system call will return unique identifier which can be used by other process to include this shared memory into their address space. After execution over, the shared memory will be detached from the process. When the last process finishes its execution, it needs to delete the shared memory created. As the shared memory segment will remain until it is removed, it is very important who to create and who to remove. Next, we are going to see about condition variables. This condition variables used to enable one thread to wake up when a condition is met. If there is no condition variable, then the waiting thread would have some other mechanism like polling. But the condition variable works with mutex. The mutex is the one which is used to make sure that only one thread accesses the shared variable at a time. Now, let us see one example how a condition variable is used. Take producer-consumer problem. The producer thread is the one which produces one item and places in a queue. The consumer is the one which takes one item from the queue and consumes it. When a producer produces add one item in a queue, first it has to acquire mutex locks. Add item in queue. If it is produced only one item, signal the consumer to wake up because then it has to previously the queue was empty and consumed have gone for sleeping. Now the queues occur to finish so the producer can release the mutex lock. Now let us come to consumer thread. Now if it is want to acquire the queue, then it has to acquire the lock and can access the queue. If the queue is empty, then the consumer has to go for sleeping. If not empty, then it can take one item from queue, and it can consume it. After the accessing over, it can release the rock. In this example, the producer go for two wake-up calls. Either walking in a single thread app or broadcast to all waiting threads. The process of wake-up in a serial because the process needs to occur mutex when it is wake-up. We have major problem with condition variables. Lost wake-up calls. These conditions occur when a wake-up signal is sent to a process and process has not sleeping. Let us take the same producer-consumer threads. In the consumer thread checking no items on queue, now it has to go for sleeping. Consider the scenario. Before occur locks, the CPU may switch the producer thread. Now the consumer has not sleeping. Now let us take the producer thread. Now the producer will produce items and place it on a queue. The queue was empty, so it has produced only one item. If this is the condition, then the producer has to wake up the consumer. So the producer will send a wake up signal to the consumer. The consumer is not sleeping. This is called lost wake up problems. Now we will move on to the next method, that is signals and events. Signals is the Unix mechanism in which one process sends signal to the other process. In this, the receiver of the message has to a signal handler, event. It is a Windows mechanism. Example, events are key press and mouse press, etc. But signals and events are only used to send some amount of data. So this approach is not good. Next, we will see message queue. The message queue can be created by calling open message queue descriptor system call. Now we'll create a message queue and return the ID. So a process can place any messages. If the process has finished its execution, then it needs to close a message queue. If all the processes are over, then the process which ends at last has to delete a message queue. That's all. Thank you.